It's an all new Gentile Living, and the kids are here. Say hi, kids.
Hi.
Today, we're going to have a craft show for you. Four different projects that you can do at home on your own, and simple as pie, whether you're 35, 4, 10, or 12. Projects for the whole family. Wow. Are you excited, kids?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll be right back. Finger painting. You got it. Cleo, do you remember when we made one of these at the library a few years ago? Do you remember how we did it?
Yeah.
Can you tell me?
Uh-huh.
How did we do it?
So first we dip the paint with our fingers or a brush.
And you then try it?
We
show
dip
me?
It.
You want to try it?
Show me how it's done.
So you to take one, or you to just use your hands to dip the paint and then put it onto the paper like this.
Good job, and that's a Christmas light. Neat. Do you want to do a lot of blue and then we can switch colors?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so the paper says, "You light up my world," and the kids can finger paint along this line. I first found this template at the Mifflin Community Library. The children's librarian, Andrea, did this craft for us back in 2021. So I made an attempt to recreate it. And I made three different kinds. Wow!
I need more.
You have blue ones.
I want to do some other colors.
Okay, that sounds good.
Well, then you use.
We also have Bryn. Can you hold up your Christmas tree picture? So you're gonna decorate that one. And Danny, you have. Oh, good. Okay, we have houses too somewhere. So there's three of these available online, printable PDFs that you can download and your kids can do at home. Okay, we'll be right back.
I thought that was my paint, but it's not.
Good job, Danny. Looks great. Good job, Brittany.
I'm done writing in blue, my favorite color.
Are we all done?
Yeah.
Hold them up for us. Good job, you guys. Oh, I like your yellow star and your blue letters. And I like your blue letters. And I like your pink letters. Yes.
Pink Very letters?
Very good. Very good, kids. I love it. And we'll be right back.
Welcome back. I'm Daniel, and this is my mom. I'm going to teach you how to make a fun snack. What is the first step? The first step is to lay a pretzel down onto the baking tray and then put down a piece of chocolate. And here we have the ingredients: pretzels, white chocolate, and M&Ms. First step is to lay a pretzel onto a baking sheet. Then put a piece of melting chocolate on top of the pretzel. Then after that gets warmed up to the point where it doesn't burn but it's still melty, you place an M&M on top, push it down, and then it'll settle and be stuck like that. And then you have a nice snack.
Do you want a grown-up's hand getting them melted?
Mm-hmm. Now we lay the chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
Good job.
Mommy.
Nice.
Then into the oven.
Okie doke. So Danny, how long?
About 3 to 5 minutes, but only until it's melted and not burnt.
Okay, well, we'll pause there, let the chocolate melt, and then we'll put the M&Ms down. You're tired. Yeah, that's okay. Oh, they're ready. Okay.
Cleo, get ready.
Yeah.
Now me and my assistant will place M&Ms on the white chocolate.
Good.
So put it carefully and push it down.
Good job.
In the middle.
Drop it.
Good job.
Drop it like it's hot. There you go. Let go. Good job.
Here, I'll do this half so that you can do these. But we gotta work fast because it might harden again and won't be melted. So can you do that one and that one for me?
Yeah. Hold on, let me do them both.
I'm really proud of you guys. You're doing awesome.
What are these arms? Have to hurry up. Hey, there's one more that doesn't have an M&M.
Can I do it?
No, I want to.
Good job. Nice.
Good job.
Okay.
There you have it.
Smile.
Snap, snap.
How is it?
Delicious.
Love it. Good job, Danny. Cleo, you want to try? Do you like it? Take another bite.
Take a big bite. Eat it all gone.
Is it good?
Mm-hmm.
Very good, you guys.
Great job, Danny. I'm proud of you and Cleo, too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's it. Hey, what up? It's Terri Gentile, astrologer, author, and psychic fortune teller. Are you ready for a reading? I mean, look at this. I like to think that the planets that are in retrograde are here to get spicy and shaken up. Let's talk about it. Two planets are in their home base, okay? And this energy is affecting all of us. So long-term changes in your career path, if you've been interested in switching to a different science field, now's the time. A lot of people are doing, you know, drastic career transitions, but they're kind of stacking their credentials up to be where they want to be. Uranus and Jupiter are both in retrograde in Taurus, so they're doing this like double whammy boomerang thing. Taurus is all over the place this year, and it's not really even their fault. They're trying out everything. And what is left after December 30th is what remains. If you're having a difficult time with a Taurus in your life, it could be that they're going through tremendous change and it's hard for them to catch up. Give them time and space to catch up. And then if they're there after December 30th, then it's really, you know, a good partnership or a good job, say. Girl, we got Neptune in retrograde in Pisces. Now let's talk about that. My dad was a Pisces, so I have my own little bias, I guess I should say. There's nothing wrong with Pisces. The thing is, like, if Pisces' needs aren't met, they don't think like everybody else. They start to, like, branch off and think their own little way, and that's fine, but then that leads for a lonely life. So come back to the community. Think not everybody's mad at you, Pisces, but I get that if it's been a difficult time, you might feel, you know, like it's taking you longer than everybody else to find your career, taking you longer to find that life partner. But think of how many people don't get to live to be your age, you know? So is it taking too long, or is there something else you could focus on in the meantime to speed things up, like say your career? Neptune also represents having compassion for ourselves and idealism. So what the perfect life could look like, maybe getting spiced up right now, you know, the salt shaker of life. That's what you're getting seasoned with. Aside from that, we have Uranus, individuality and inventiveness. So you're reinventing yourself. Look, I toned it down. Mm-hmm. How about you? What are you doing differently? My daughter got this Fenty beauty stick. It's amazing. It's the best thing I've ever used. Thank you, YouTube, TikTok for kids. One more Jupiter baby. Jupiter retrograde, Jupiter in Taurus, and Jupiter is the ruling planet for Sagittarius. So we're talking good luck, good fortune, abundance. We're talking moving into the right place after a start and stop, frustrating experience like bumper cars. Ugh, just be done and moved in now. I also see that Sagittarius might be going over something again with a Pisces in their life. And the thing is, you're supposed to just flush that and move forward, not stay stuck back there, okay? Sagittarius and Pisces, I get it. The Sag makes the Pisces feel seen a little bit, but the Sag is all the surface, okay? And they can't go to that depth that the Pisces needs. So if you're finding yourself frustrated, take a break. That's all. Right now, Libra is occupied by Venus, the planet of love. So that means relationships may feel more balanced right now. Next Monday, December 4th, Venus is going to transit into Scorpio. So love is going to have a little bit of a death and dying season, death and regeneration. Any questions, hit me up, book a reading online, and I'll talk soon. I'm Terri Gentile, and this is Readings with Terri.
Going to add some paprika, pepper,
and
little rosemary, one of my favorite spices. Now we're going to create a pie pan. Take an egg wash. Mix an egg with about 2 tablespoons of water and paint it on a pie.
And this will
we'll be right back.
Welcome back to Gentle Living. Today, we're going to do a snowman craft. So, we're going to start out with a sock. And you're going to take a cookie cutter, any cookie cutter, and you're going to put it in the sock to make up space. So you're gonna put it in. You're gonna take rice, and you can use tools, you don't have to. And then you're gonna fill up the sock. That's about full. Now you're gonna take the cookie cutter out, and you're gonna twist a little head. So you're gonna twist it and then slam it down. And then you're gonna take this little floof that he has and tie it around his head. Now we're gonna decorate him. We take the fuzzy sock and we cut it into pieces. Let's put on his hat. Now for a scarf. We have the snowman done now. Now I'm gonna grab some markers. And a carrot nose. I have two eyes, a mouth, some buttons, and a nose. Thanks for watching.
That's our show for you today. Thanks for watching Gentle Living, and we'll see you next time. Bye.